going to be talking about text and data mining, an exciting technique to get lots of information fast so you can get on with your research. Text and data mining, or TDM, is a process through which large amounts of information can be analysed electronically. This allows researchers to work through far more research content than they would ever be able to do manually. Imagine having to go through thousands of papers looking for a specific term or keyword. It would take a ridiculously long period of time, and that would be if a single researcher just looked at abstracts and conclusions, let alone reading each individual paper cover to cover. TDM can be used for things other than going through research papers, such as working through data sets to identify trends and patterns. TDM is extremely useful in the sciences, especially in areas such as medical research, where analysing for occurrences of certain diseases in the literature. However, TDM doesn't have to be limited to these sorts of applications and can be used across disciplines, such as in linguistics for language frequency and conservation for species tracking or associated content. A lot of TDM options are made possible due to individuals coding and building programs that can carry out automated analysis. If you saw our video on alternative communities, you'll know that GitHub is a goldmine for finding programs and code written by others, especially if you do not have the knowledge to start such a program from scratch. One local Cambridge project that uses GitHub as part of its development process is ContentMine. ContentMine is an ever-developing set of tools and does a lot of work with literature reviews and other research-based analysis. Headed up by Cambridge chemist Peter Murray Rust, who is also funded by the Shuttleworth Foundation, ContentMine has been used to discover research papers on the Zika virus, search for species on the IUCN endangered list, as well as analysing clinical trial reviews. However, there are some limitations with TDM, with the biggest relating to copyright. TDM works by making a copy of a resource so a program can analyse it and then typically discards that copy once the analysis is done. Ordinarily, this type of wholesale copying would be illegal under UK copyright law, but there is an exception in the instance of computational analysis for non-commercial research, which is good news for anyone working in academia. Unfortunately, it isn't all good news. Currently, it is illegal to apply these sorts of techniques to the services where many researchers find literature for their work, databases. Many articles and other such research comes via large databases such as JSTOR or Science Direct, and due to the infrastructure and hosting investments on the part of the provider, these are protected by a database right, which means they aren't open for TDM access. Some providers do offer their own APIs for analysis, but this means using someone else's program rather than the one you diligently built for a specific purpose. All is not lost, however. There are open peer-reviewed resources out there that can be used in conjunction with TDM, such as Europe PubMed Central, and open datasets via Wikidata. Also, many within the academic community are campaigning to have more open access to data and research so that TDM can be carried out legally and with complete access to the world's literature without hindrance. It should be noted that this introduction is deliberately general to give an overview of a research technique and some of its limitations. If you wish to use TDM in your work, we highly recommend that you ensure you are doing so legally and that you contact like-minded folks such as the team at ContentMine to ask for advice. So that was a quick look at text and data mining, which I hope was a helpful look at something new and exciting to try out as part of your research. So until next time, bye.